Okay, assalamu alaikum. In the previous lecture, we started speaking about the brain, first part of the central nervous system. We said that the brain is divided into three main components, the forebrain, which includes the cerebrum and the encephalon, the midbrain, and the hindbrain, which is composed of pons, medulla, and cerebellum. We start speaking about the cerebrum, the first part, and we divided the cerebrum into four lobes. We said that the cerebrum is divided into four lobes by sulci. Those lobes are the frontal lobe, which is separated from the parietal lobe by central sulcus. There is also the temporal lobe, which is separated from both frontal and parietal by lateral sulcus. And we said we have an occipital lobe, which is separated from the parietal by parieto-occipital sulcus. إذا بعدكم صحيحين or remembering what we were speaking about. Now, we ended up into what we call it functional localization of the brain. But before we start speaking about this, we just need to go a little bit over the topography of the brain. When scientists try to give names, nomenclature for the brain structures, gyri and sulci mainly, okay? Because we agreed that in the cerebrum, we have gyri and sulci, foldings. So that's why they start dividing the brain into four lobes. So any gyrus within the temporal lobe will be called temporal gyrus. Any gyrus in the frontal lobe, it will be called frontal gyrus. The same for the sulci. The exceptions are the ones which I mentioned to you. There you have an exception of the central sulcus and precentral gyrus and postcentral gyrus, okay? We have the lateral sulcus. Those are the sulci which are the borders, okay? We mentioned them. The four main sulci, the central, lateral, parieto-occipital, medially, and the calcarine sulcus. However, so when you look to any gyrus, for example, if we took the temporal lobe, the most obvious example. So in the temporal lobe, we can see three elevations. One, two, and three. There is another one down. So we have three gyri. So we call them temporal gyri, okay? And based on their location, the most superior gyrus here in the temporal lobe will be called superior temporal gyrus, okay? The one in the middle here, middle temporal gyrus. The most inferior one, inferior temporal gyrus. That's how we name the gyri. The same for sulci. Three gyri, kam sulcus bainhum? One, two. So the superior one is the superior temporal sulcus within the temporal lobe. The inferior one is inferior temporal sulcus. The same if you go to the frontal lobe. This one here would be the superior frontal gyrus. The one here in the middle, you see it? Middle frontal gyrus. The most inferior one here, inferior frontal gyrus. And the sulci are the same. Superior frontal sulcus, inferior frontal sulcus. Okay? Is this clear? Okay, now there are some exceptions, okay, based on the description, and we will go over them as we start speaking about the functional localization of the brain. What we mean by functional localization of the brain, when we speak about the brain in general, including the cerebrum, we say that each certain location or area in the brain is carrying out a certain function. Okay? So that's what we mean by functional localization of the brain. اللي هو specialty. يعني في ناس تخصص تصير دكاترة تشتغل دكتور فقط. الانجينير بيشتغل انجينير. The same. When we look to the brain, precentral gyrus is the area of motor function. Primary motor area, that's it. That's its function, nothing else. That's what we mean by functional localization of the brain. Each location has its own certain function. The most important functions that you need to know, okay? You need to know, okay? In this class, will include the primary motor area in the brain or in the cerebrum, which will be, so because we will go over the brain, when we go over each part, we will speak. So the first part we are studying now is the cerebrum. So in the cerebrum, the main functional regions in the cerebrum will include the primary motor area. Where is this? The precentral gyrus. Okay, we spoke about it, okay, in the previous lecture. The primary sensory area in the postcentral gyrus. Okay, now in addition to those, you have the auditory area. Auditory, what does auditory mean? Hearing. You hear sounds. Sounds, okay? Not language, okay? Sounds. This is the sound of a car. This is the sound of a bird. This is the sound of the professor talking, okay? You don't need to understand, but you need to distinguish this sound, okay? So the auditory or hearing area from audio, okay? It's interpretation of sounds. It's usually located here in the middle of this gyrus. Which gyrus is this? Superior temporal gyrus. In the middle of the superior temporal gyrus, very close to the area of the ear, you will have the sound interpretation area, the auditory area. Okay? This is called auditory area. Visual area, I told you, when we speak about visual area, اللي هي منطقة الinterpretation of vision, we said that most of the occipital lobe is carrying out this function, okay? It's located in the occipital lobe, however, it is mostly concentrated in a certain sulcus. Where is that? So if you look here in the medial view, this is the parieto-occipital sulcus, this is the occipital lobe, okay? So all of this lobe is carrying the visual area. However, it's mostly concentrated in this sulcus. شو سميناها هاي السلكس؟ The calcarine sulcus, okay? Calcarine or calcarine, both are correct. The calcarine or calcarine sulcus. So the visual area in the occipital lobe mostly concentrated where? In the calcarine sulcus. Two important areas related to language, vernicus and brucus. Vernicus and the brucus area. So, start with vernicus, referring to a German scientist, Karl Wernicke, who described it for the first time. Vernicus area is the language interpretation area. So this is not for sound, this is for language now, okay? You understand the spoken words to you, okay? So first, this area is usually located also within the superior temporal gyrus. However, not in the middle. This here is the auditory area. Behind it, here, in the posterior part of the superior temporal gyrus, you will have the vernicus area. So the location, posterior part of superior temporal gyrus. So first, you have the hearing signals going from your ear into the auditory area. So you will distinguish the sound in the auditory area. This is the sound of the professor speaking. What is he speaking? You cannot interpret that. The signals will go posteriorly into vernicus area, and within the vernicus area now, you will start to explain or translate, okay, these words into a meaning, okay? So that's what we mean by vernicus area. Vernicus area, as much languages you know more, with more words, okay, vernicus area usually become more specialized and more enlarged, so more neurons involved. So sometimes even it extends all the way into the parietal lobe, behind the lateral fissure. So it's usually in the posterior part of superior temporal gyrus. However, it can expand up more superiorly, okay? The vernicus area. The third area related to speech and language is Broca's area. Paul Broca, French surgeon who described it, okay? That's why they call it Broca's area or the motor speech area. So we have language interpretation, then we have the motor speech area, okay? Motor speech area or Broca's area is usually located where? In this gyrus. This is one, this is two, this is three. Inferior frontal gyrus, okay? In the inferior frontal gyrus. So Broca's area in the inferior frontal gyrus, neurons here are related with the planning and the production of the speech in a comprehensive way, in a proper manner. So in building sentences in a proper way, okay? That's what we mean by comprehension of a speech. It's located in the inferior frontal gyrus. So, when I ask your colleague, what is your name? So the first signal he will receive in the auditory area as a sound. This is the sound of the professor. Now the signals will go into Wernicke's area. In the Wernicke's area, he will interpret this sound or these words. What is your name? So he's asking me about my name. To respond to the question now, the signals will go into Broca's area. And Broca's area neurons will stimulate, okay, his muscles, speaking muscles, okay, the muscles of speech and the muscles of the tongue to say, my name is, whatever his name, okay? Is this clear? So three important areas right together. The sound area, the language interpretation, then the motor speech area. By the way, those two areas are only located in one hemisphere, in the dominant hemisphere, not in both, okay? So if you are a right-handed, Broca's and Wernicke's are located in the left side, okay? In your left hemisphere only, okay? They are mostly in the dominant hemisphere. If you are left-handed, some of the left-handed, it is located in the right. However, some of the left-handed, it's also still in the left side, okay? So in general, you can say that Broca's and Wernicke's area are usually in the left hemisphere of the cerebrum in more than 90% of the population, okay? Whether they are right or left-handed. So they are located mostly in the dominant hemisphere or in the left hemisphere of the population. Broca's aphasia, now, one of aphasia disorders, A means without. Always remember this. In medicine, when we add the letter A, it means without. Aphasia, ability to speak. Okay? So aphasia is an ability to speak. However, so many disorders can lead to aphasia. Okay? Some of them will even like damage to the muscles of the tongue, damage to the hypoglossal nerve, which innervates the tongue itself. Okay, so however, if the damage happened in the inferior frontal gyrus of the left side or in the Broca's area, okay, this will be referred to as Broca's aphasia. It's difficulty of speech due to damage to Broca's aphasia. So in this case, still Wernicke's area is functional, auditory area is functional, so when you speak to a person, he understands what you are saying, okay? He understands you, he knows. But the problem is that he cannot produce the words, okay? He cannot say the word. He knows the word, but he cannot say it, okay? That's why he cannot express himself, we say, okay? And in this case, they call it the expressive aphasia, okay? Expressive aphasia because patient is capable to understand, he knows what he wants to say, but he cannot express himself or say it, okay? So they call it expressive aphasia or non-fluent aphasia, okay? Remember, this is not stuttering. Stuttering اللي هي This is not. He does not stutter. Stuttering is a different psychological or neuromuscular disorder, okay? This here is a different situation. This is a damage to an area in the brain that produces difficulty in speech. A simple example is this patient who suffers from a stroke, cerebrovascular attack leading to inability to speech.
Scott. Oh, Greg. Sarah Scott, that's right. And how old are you? I can't.
So she cannot say how old she is, but she knows how old she is.
What happened? school and English class.
Okay.
And I book and I read it aloud, but I can't because strike. And so I sign that. And also, it's the same as the same kind of thing as
pins and needles.
Yeah, the same, and also farmers, but.
So just to show you that it's not stuttering, okay? It's difficulty in the production of words, okay? Okay, continue now with other parts of the brain. So what you need to know about the functional localization in cerebrum, not in the brain, we will continue the other parts of it. In cerebrum, just these six areas, okay? The motor, the sensory, auditory, the visual, the Broca's and Wernicke's. Other parts in the forebrain, we said previously, we have something called diencephalon. If you remember, this is the diencephalon area. It's called diencephalon because it's made up of two structures within the cerebrum. You cannot see them, encephalon. Those two structures, we refer to them as the thalamus, which means the chamber, I told you, or the bedroom, okay? That's why they call it thalamus. It's keep hidden, okay, within the cerebrum. And the area below the thalamus, we call it hypothalamus, okay? So we have a thalamus and hypothalamus. The thalamus actually is an oval mass, بيضاوية, of gray matter. What is the gray matter? It's the area that contains nerve cell bodies and dendrites, yes? So it's an area of nerve cell bodies within the core of the cerebrum. So it's a nucleus, okay? It's a gray matter which contains many nuclei. So it's built up of many nuclei. Brain nuclei are areas of gray matter completely surrounded by white matter. So that's the thalamus, a group of nuclei, a group of neurons gathered within the cerebrum, okay? It occupies 80% of the diencephalon. فإحنا لما بنحكي على diencephalon هاد ذكروا 80% thalamus, 20% الهايبوثالاموس فقط, okay? Occupies 80%. In some people, okay, 70% من the humans, if you talk to the thalamus, you will see in the middle there is a connection. This is called interthalamic connection, which connects the two thalami on each side together, okay? So this is a thalamus, this is the other mass, okay, of the thalamus, and they both are connected with each other by interthalamic connection. What's the function of this region of the thalamus? In general, you will study that more details in neuroscience, but in general, the thalamus is the major relay station for sensory pathways. Relay means distribution, okay? It's a major distribution station for sensory pathways. Let's say more than 90% of the sensory pathways اللي بتدخل عندك على البرين, before they go to their area, they have to pass into the thalamus. والثalamus هي محطة التوزيع. Okay? That will distribute these signals into their proper location. For example, the vision signals comes from the eye through optic nerve. They don't go directly to the occipital lobe. They go to the thalamus first. And within the thalamus, the neurons in the thalamus there will take this signal and say, this is a vision, go to the occipital lobe and calcarine sulcus, okay? Is this clear? When you touch a hot cup of coffee with your hand, okay, by your right hand, okay, this will go all the way into the thalamus. In the thalamus now, this signal, the neurons in the thalamus will take this signal and send it where? To the most central gyrus, okay, where? More inferiorly, in inverted way, into the left, okay? Left post-central gyrus, okay? In the lower half of the post-central gyrus. If you are walking, okay, and hit on a sharp object, like a nail, a severe pain, this pain signal will go all the way into the thalamus. And in the thalamus, the neurons there will take this signal and send it to where? To the post central gyrus superiorly, of the opposite side. If you're the right, to the left post central gyrus, in the superior part of the post central gyrus. Okay? So Thalamus is the distribution station for sensory pathways. Is this clear? So that's the main thing you need to know only about the thalamus. It's a major relay station for sensory pathways. What about the hypothalamus? The hypothalamus, this structure here. Okay, so this is the thalamus. This is the interthalamic connection. This is here is the hypothalamus. The hypothalamus is an area where neurons here or nerve cells are specialized in secreting hormones. Okay? Those called neurohormones. Okay? So hypothalamus contains special nerve cells that secrete hormones, neurohormones. Okay? These neurohormones will go and stimulate or inhibit the pituitary gland. شو هي البيتويتاري جلاند؟ الغدة النخامية. The major endocrine gland in your body, which in turn will regulate or control other endocrine glands. Okay? Like the testes, like the thyroid, okay? The parathyroid, the adrenal glands, all these endocrine glands. طبعا اللي بتحكم فيهم هي البيتويتاري جلاند، اوكي؟ عن طريق ايش؟ الهرمونز اللي بتفرزها، الجونادوتروبين ريليزنج هرمونز، اوكي؟ لايك افاساتش والاتش اذا سمعتوا فيهم، ذيز هرمونز، بس شو اللي بتحكم بالبيتويتاري اتسلف؟ ذا نيرفس سيستم. هاو ذا نيرفس سيستم كنترولز ذا بيتويتاري جلاند؟ ثرو ذا هايبوثالامس. So the hypothalamus is the area that connects two systems together, the nervous and the endocrine system. Okay? So, the hypothalamus contains special nerve cells that secrete hormones. These hormones, we refer to them as hypothalamus releasing hormones. Hypothalamus releasing hormones, okay, they will usually go into the pituitary gland and stimulate pituitary gland to secrete its hormones, okay, which will either stimulate or inhibit, okay, other endocrine glands in the body. It secretes other hormones like vasopressin, or we call it antidiuretic hormone because it inhibits duration, urination, loss of fluid. And vasopressin because it stimulates the contraction of smooth muscles in the blood vessels. So it will produce vasoconstriction. Okay? And to in physics, when the tube is constricted, the speed of the fluid increases. Okay? So when this hormone is secreted, it will constrict the blood vessels. So the speed of the fluid will increase. So it will increase the pressure. Okay? To raise the blood pressure. Okay? And also it will prevent urination. Antidiuretic hormone, it will keep water in your body. By this also it will increase blood pressure. So this hormone is secreted by hypothalamus when you have usually what? Loss of a fluid, okay? When you have dehydration or when you have low blood pressure, hypotension, okay? So it's secreted by the hypothalamus. It's stored where? In the pituitary gland, yes. It's stored in the pituitary gland until it's required. Retention of water from the kidneys, vasoconstriction of the blood vessels. By this, hypothalamus is linking two systems. What are these? Nervous with endocrine system, okay? Go down below the hypothalamus. Now, this is here the thalamus, you see? This is the thalamus. Below it here is the hypothalamus. Now we leave the forebrain completely and we get into a small area here. This is small area below the forebrain and above the hindbrain. It is the midbrain. When you look to the midbrain, okay, midbrain is a very small area that's located in the middle of the brain, okay? And if you look carefully to it and from front, you will see it has two swellings on each side, okay? These swellings, we call them crus cerebri. And what are these crus cerebri? Crus means leg, okay, or foot, okay? Leg, it means leg, the crura, okay? It's leg, so those are the legs of the cerebrum above all the way, because they resemble that. That's why they call them crus cerebri. However, if we take a cross section, if we cut this midbrain and look to it from above, okay, we will see this structure here. So this is the internal structure of the midbrain, downward. Those are the legs which I told you about. This elevation and this is the other one, okay? Which we see them here from anterior, okay? So if you look from above, you can see these two elevations, the crus cerebri. However, when scientists look to the midbrain, They just divide the midbrain into two parts, anterior part and posterior part, based on this cavity. This cavity here is called cerebral aqueduct. Okay? The cerebral aqueduct. Okay. انتهى. If you look in this sagittal view, this is the midbrain هون. شايفينه؟ This is thalamus, hypothalamus, انتهى الفوربرين. الآن هذا الجزء الصغير هو المدبرين. Within the midbrain, you will see this duct here, this cavity. This is called cerebral aqueduct. We will speak later about it. Cerebral aqueduct. Aque means aqueous. شو الأقويس؟ Fluid. وduct قناة تحمل fluid. Okay? From the forebrain down into the brain stem. That's why they call it the cerebral aqueduct. It contains the fluid. This is called the cerebrospinal fluid. We will speak about it. Okay? The CSF. However, so neuroscientists divide the midbrain based on this duct into anterior part and a small posterior part. Okay? Now, if you look to this structure, which we call it brain stem. Do you remember the brain stem? We said brain stem is a term in the brain which indicates the presence of midbrain, pons, and medulla oblongata. If you look to the brain stem in your in the human brain, it's usually inclined, mayan. Okay, it's not going vertical. So that's why, okay, when you look to it, the anterior part is located more inferior, while the posterior part of it, of the brain stem, is located more superior. The brain stem in your brain is inclined like this. فالجزء الخلفي بصير posterior superior. والجزء الأمامي بدل ما يظل أمامي بصير anterior inferior. Okay. That's why when scientists divide the midbrain into two parts by this duct, the posterior part هذا الخلفي منه سموه tectum. Tectum is a Latin word which means the roof, السقف. Because now it becomes more superior, like the roof of the midbrain. So they call it the tectum. So if you look in a cross section for midbrain, this is the cerebral aqueduct. This posterior part of it, بسميه ايش؟ tectum. The anterior part, all of this, is divided into two peduncles, سموهم. Cerebral peduncles. Right and left peduncle. Peduncle تصغير بيديكل. وإذا درستوا بالبون في إشي بالفيرتبرا اسمها بيديكل ولامينا. شو البيديكل؟ القدم, the foot, okay؟ واللامينا الصفيحة, okay؟ Because it's like a blade, okay؟ And that's why they call them pedicel and lamina. The foot of the vertebra and the blade, which connected to the foot. But this is cerebral peduncle. Peduncle صار معناها إيش؟ A small foot, okay؟ تصغير القدم, okay؟ So it has two small foot or feet, two small feet, the cerebral peduncles, okay? That's why we call the anterior part of the midbrain cerebral peduncles, two. The posterior part, tectum, one structure, the roof, the tectum. In the cerebral peduncle now, there are three important structures. The most anterior one here, and it's a completely myelinated axons, you see them here. White matter, completely white matter, anterior part هذا. White matter يعني إيش؟ Myelinated axons. This is the crust cerebri, which you saw it earlier here. The swelling. This is swelling and this is swelling is the crust cerebri. فالcrust cerebri هو جزء من cerebral peduncle. Okay? And it's completely white matter. ليش white matter? Because it contains myelinated axons. That's coming down from the precentral gyrus. اللي هي ايش البريسنترال جايروس في السيريبرم؟ The motor area. So most of these are motor neurons that will descend down from here across the brain stem down into the spinal cord. And from the spinal cord, they will be distributed through the nerves in your body into the skeletal muscles. Okay? So those are which you call it the corticospinal or tract or the motor bundles. Of neurons, okay? فهذول هم الحزم تعيت الموتور نيورونز which will go down, okay, into their skeletal muscles later on. So we call them the motor neurons, okay? myelinated axons of motor neurons in the precentral gyrus. وراء مباشرة للكراس سيريبري هذا الوايت ماتر a black substance, gray matter, but completely black. Okay? فبيسموها the black substance أو substantia nigra. Okay? Substantia substance, nigra, black. Black substance or the substantia nigra. This is very important area because the neurons here are heavily pigmented. فيهم صبغة اسمها الميلانين نفسها اللي في السكن عندك. Okay? They are heavily pigmented by melanin. But more important, they secrete a very important inhibitory transmitter. It's called dopamine. Those are dopaminergic neurons. Okay? بفرزوا neurotransmitter اسمها dopamine, inhibitory. بتمنع هاك neurotransmitter بتمنع ال contraction of signaling, the stimulation of nerves of what? Of antisynergistic muscles. يعني لما بدي أعمل flexion في biceps وفي triceps. الكونتراكشن في البايسبس من البري سنترال جايروس. الان نيورونز ان سبستانشيا نيجرا ويل سيكريت دوبامين تو انهبيت النيرف سيلز اللي بتغذي الترايسبس من انها ايش؟ تنقبض. اوكي؟ فا ايزيلي دو ذيس. اذا تدمرت السبستانشيا نيجرا، if these neurons are damaged, اوكي؟ So there will be what? Loss of inhibitory signals. تفقد الانهبيتوري سيجنال. فبصير في very difficult rigidity of movement وين ما تحرك. اوكي rigidity in movement وبصير فيش inhibition وانت جالس للمسل بصير ايدك ترعش لحالها during rest situation. This is called Parkinson's disease. اذا سمعتوا فيه the Parkinson's disease is because of damage to this area to the substantia nigra to the dopaminergic neurons in the substantia nigra. Famous people have suffered previously like Muhammad Ali Clay, إذا سمعت فيه, a famous boxer. Okay, from damage to substantia nigra, leading to Parkinsonism. إذا في الميد برين في كراس سيريبري, الوايت ماتر اللي تحتوي الموتور نيورونز, لو تدمر الكراس سيريبري شو بصير معك؟ Paralysis. You cannot move your muscles. These are the motor neurons to the skeletal muscles. Okay, if they are damaged, you will have a complete paralysis. Okay? You will have something called the quadriplegia or hemiplegia, depending on the side it is damaged. Either both, complete loss of your muscles, limbs. Quadriplegia, shalal ruba'i. If one side, hemiplegia in the opposite side. Right, you see hemiplegia in left. Left, hemiplegia in right. Okay, either damage to substantia nigra, shu bisir? Parkinson's disease. Behind the substantia nigra now, we have an area here called the tegmentum. With tegmentum is a mixed area, as you see. It contains white matter and gray matter. The most famous gray matter there is the red nucleus. احنا بنسميها red nucleus. هي red because of high vascularity of the blood there and because of iron containing pigments. ومش مطلوب منكم تعرفوا اكثر من انه بس منطقة اسمها التجمنتم. اوكي؟ فاذا لما بنطلع في الميدبرين جزئين تكتم وسيريبرال بيدنكل. اوكي؟ Based on the cerebral aqueduct separation. Cerebral peduncle, crust cerebri, substantia nigra, and tegmentum. Tegmentum معناها السقيفة, the second floor. Okay? Because this is the first floor, this is the second floor, this is the roof, the tectum. ذكروا إنه مايل, midbrain. Okay? So, crust cerebri, tegmentum, substantia nigra, located all in the, where? In the cerebral peduncle. Nuclei of cranial nerves, لما بنيجي لهم راح نحكي عنهم. Remember you have 12 cranial nerves, هذول جزء من ال peripheral nervous system. Okay. ثلاثة وأربعة بيطلعوا من ال midbrain. This is three and number four from behind. ثلاثة وأربعة بيطلعوا من ال midbrain, بس راح نحكي عنهم later on. خليني بس أخلص آخر إشي في ال pons والمدلة وبعدين بترككم. اوكي بعد الميد برين بنيجي على الهايند برين حكينا الفورث برين اللي هو السيريبرم والدايينسيفالون ثلاماس وهايبوثلاماس حكينا الميد برين الان بضل عندي الهايند برين الهايند برين بتكون من بونز ميدولا وبلونجاتا اند سيريبيلم اوكي اند اي بوت تو يو كويستشن هير تو ديستينجويش هايند برين فروم سمثينج كولد برين ستيم ذا برين ستيم اجين از ميد برين بونز اند medulla oblongata. This is the brain stem. The hind brain does not contain midbrain. The hind brain is the lowest part. Pons, medulla, and cerebellum. Pons, زي ما حكيت لكم, which means the bridge. Okay? It's located anterior to the cerebellum, as you see here, anterior to the cerebellum. Also the medulla, anterior, inferior to the cerebellum. The main functions of the bones, أول إشي من اسمه, bridge. Because it's bridging the two cerebellar hemispheres. It's bridging the two parts of cerebellum together. It contains bundles of axons, myelinated axons, هون. كلهم هذول, شايفينهم كيف transversely رايحات. Okay, that connects the two halves of the cerebellum. This is very important function you have to know about the bones. It contains also the central of arousal. This is very important in the bones. شو يعني arousal? Wake up from sleep. The center for wake-sleep cycle, okay? Which we call it locus coeruleus, okay? The locus coeruleus, the center of wake-sleep cycle, is usually located in the upper part of the bones posteriorly, however, not here, okay? So it controls arousal, okay? Waking up from sleep, okay? In the bones, it connects the two halves of the cerebellum, and it contains the nuclei. شو يعني nuclei? Nerve cell bodies of certain cranial nerves. The cranial nerve هو عبارة عن إيش؟ عن myelinated axons. Okay, these myelinated axons, where is the nerve cell bodies of them? They are the nuclei, okay, of cranial nerves. The nuclei of the cranial nerves number 3 و4 في midbrain. فبده يحتوي 5 و6 و7 and half of 8. Okay, remember this. Cranial nerve number 5, 6, and 7. Okay, mainly. 5 اسمه the trigeminal nerve, 6 اسمه the abducens, و7 اسمه the facial. راح نحكي عنهم. Okay. And part of 8 also. 3 و4 في midbrain, 5 و6 و7 في bones, 8 in the middle, spanning the junction of bones and medulla. وبعدين بضل عندكم بعد 8, 9 و10 و12, انسوا 11. Okay. 9 و10 و12 في medulla oblongata, which is the last part of the brain, the lowest part of the brain and the lowest part of brain stem even. This is the brain stem, midbrain bones, medulla. It's very important structure. Why it's very important? لأنه في medulla oblongata في عندكم two important centers, by the way. You have something called cardiovascular center and the respiratory center. Okay, those two centers contain nerve cells that control the speed of heart beating and the speed of respiratory rate. Okay, فإذا دمروا هذول السنترز, يعني إذا صار دمج في المدلة أوبلونجاتا, you will have a result of direct death. Okay, a direct death. فما يغركم إن هذا the lowest part of the brain. Okay, medulla oblongata, if you look anteriorly to it, you will see that in the middle there is a very deep fissure, بسميه median fissure. It's very deep because of two large swellings on each side. هذول هم بسميهم the pyramids. If you bring a scalpel, إذا جبتوا مشرط, and you cut this connective tissue here, you will go inside, okay, you will see many myelinated axons. Those are the same myelinated motor neuron axons here in the crus cerebri, which descend down all the way to become here what? The pyramids. Okay? هم نفسهم المotor neurons, okay? Myelinated axons of motor neurons, which descends down from the crus cerebri across the bones into the medulla. So that's what does the pyramids. The pyramids contain the bundles of motor neurons that located up in the precentral gyrus. Okay? At the lower part here, you see, of the medulla, the two pyramids will cross over. اليمين بيروح شمال والشمال بيروح يمين عبر بعض like this. بدخلوا النيورونز ببعضهم وبيروحوا, they cross over to the opposite side. This is which we call it the decussation of the pyramids. So the motor bundles will cross over to the opposite side at the lowest, مش lower, lowest part of medulla oblongata. Just above the spinal cord. And this is which we call it the decussation of the pyramids. How is Muthani? The great motor decussation. Okay? Or decussation of the pyramids. Contains the cranial nerve nuclei of 9, 10, 12. Okay? Forget about 11. and I will later on tell you why. ففي عندي ميديان فيشر two pyramids وtwo elevations بسميهم الأوليفز من شكلهم زي حبة الزيتون. But not that's why they call them olives. They call them olives because here we have very important nucleus called inferior olivary nucleus. Inferior olivary nucleus producing this bulge here in the medulla, and it's very important center for motor coordination. تنسيق الحركات. Coordination between the skeletal muscles, okay? To produce a very fine movements. آخر واحد راح نحكي عنه السيريبيلم. عشر البرين ماس is the cerebellum, بس نص النيورونز موجودات فيه. حكيت لكم اياها المرة الماضية. سألتكم ليش؟ بسبب هاي الفانكشن. لأنه الفانكشن of cerebellum mainly includes three important things. أول شيء البالانس in your body. يعني الإكوليبريم. اوكي؟ تعرف توقف. البوستشر تحافظ على وقفتك. And producing a very fine delicate movements. Those fine delicate movements requires high coordination between skeletal muscles. So coordination of the muscle tones and movements to produce very highly delicate movements. مثل إيش delicate movements؟ لما بتطبعوا على الكيبورد بدك تعرف تحرك إصبع هون، أوكي؟ ولما بتيجي تعزف بيانو، أوكي؟ أو تعزف جيتار. All of these لما بدك تدخل تخيط تدخل الخيط بثقب الإبرة. Requires a very highly concentration and coordination between the muscles. Okay, so this is why the cerebellum contains a high number of neurons. Okay, because it's responsible for the fine, delicate movements. مثل لما أحكي لك, put the tip of your index finger at the tip of your nose. This movement. Okay, and this you need the muscles that flex the fingers to contract. بس لو فليكسور ديجيتورم اللي بتروح للاندكس ما بدي اياها تكونتراكت. شوفوا كيف الديليكيشن بدي الاكستنسور اندسز هنا هي اللي كونتراكت. اوكي سو شوفوا كيف هاي المصل الاكستنسور اندسز مع الاكستنسور ديجيتورم مع الفليكسور ديجيتورم بدهم ينسقوا، بعدين البايسبس بدها تنسق معهم، والشولدر المصل انتيرير اوف ذا شولدر اوف دلتويد انتيرير دلتويد بدها تساعد في الابدكشن وفي الكونتراكشن انتل تاتشنج. فاول ذيز مسلز of your upper limb have to coordinate and to produce this fine delicate movement. All of this coordination happened where? In the cerebellum. Okay, and two nuclei help the cerebellum. Those are the red nucleus and the inferior olivary nucleus. When there is a damage to the cerebellum, okay, a common disease is that degeneration of these neurons. هذول ال 50 مليار خلية بيبدو يموتوا بسبب جينيتيك او مش معروف، بيبدا يصيرهم ديجينريشن وذ ايج، بيبدو يموتوا. لما يبدو يموتوا بصير بالسيريبيلم ديزيز بسميه ايتاكسيا. الايتاكسيا اي مينز without، حكيت لكم دائما، وتاكسيا اوردر، الميشنت بيفقد الاوردر تاعه. So there will be loss of muscle coordination. And this will lead to damage to what? To cerebellum. Okay, so the patient will be unable to do fine delicate movements as needling, typing or playing a piano. بفقد كل هاي الحركات. Okay, والتست إلها two tests بسيطات بسميهم finger to nose test. بسأل البيشنت to put the index finger opposite to what? To the tip of his nose. أو بمشي الهيل اللي هي الأنكل over the shin. In slang American the shin is the tibia. Okay, فبسأله تمشي الشن over the tibia. Just two important tests to detect ataxia. Or remember, ataxia is damage to cerebellum. Okay, in this patient, right side normal. Okay, this indicates. شوفوا left side here. When he wants to put the tip of his index against his nose. Yeah, this is ataxia. That means a damage. To which cerebellum, right or left? So the only difference here is that the nerve neurons in the cerebellum do not decussate. Neurons of cerebellum are over decussate. Decussate then decussate. فبرجعوا لنفس السايد. So what I want you just to know that cerebellum عكس cerebrum. Cerebellum containing the same side of your body. Right cerebellum to the right body, left cerebellum to the left body. So when we say here we have a damage in the, his left side, that means the damage in the left cerebellar hemisphere, okay? But what's controlling his left side is the right cerebral hemisphere, okay? Is cerebrum, opposite side. Cerebellum, same side, okay? Remember this. This is the heel to shin test. بسموه heel to shin, اللي هو الانكل to tibia in your anatomical language. Heel to shin test, he has to move his heel over the shin. He cannot produce this fine, delicate movement because of damage to neurons. And by the way, this is a common disorder in children in Jordan. Of due to idiopathic theosis, طبعا, or genetics. يعطيكم العافية. Next lecture we will continue.